Previously on Republic of Doyle.
Your purse, it's real.
My Prada purse is missing, and I think Rose took it.
So what if she did?
I have drugs in the purse.
I may need you to come bail me out.
This was in Kathleen's purse.
Why does Kathleen have a gun?
I had a guy out west who was stalking me for a while.
Kathleen's got a friend of hers, some guy, Eric.
So what's with Buddy?
He's just a friend, baby.
I miss hanging out with you. We could go for a walk or something?
Yeah, I don't know how I feel, but it's something, like, weird.
I was thinking we could do something maybe separately.
Des, is everything okay?
My dad taught me how to tie one of these in case my husband needed it.
So you in the market?
Can you hurry up, please? Listen, do not be stingy with the dressing and gravy this time.
Oh, I am insulted. Truly. This is a respectable chip truck, and the accusation that I would misrepresent the quantity of posted portions is ludicrous, my friend. Ludicrous.
Yeah, I know. You're a persecuted soul.
Bye-bye. I'm away.
You're some slow.
Yeah, look, don't worry.
All right, I'll get the chips and the fish, and you can start clogging your arteries in no time. Bag it.
Great chefs cannot be rushed, Jake. He knows that, Bob.
Jake. Jake.
Yeah, I gotta go. I'll be back in a minute.
Hey, hot cop. How you doing? You look fantastic today, by the way. Isn't it just such great luck, you know, running into you on such a beautiful day? I think fate is shining on us.
Oh, yeah, fate, is it? I don't happen to return your 7 phone messages, and you just find me on my way to a car.
Well, fate, destiny, small town, whatever. You know, it all works for me.
Listen, Jake, I'm not in the mood, okay? So what do you want?
I don't want nothing. I just thought maybe, you know, we'd have a little chat.
I don't want to chat. Go away.
Okay, well, what's wrong with talking? You know, talking's good.
Go away. Shoo.
Shoo? Did you just shoo me?
I'll do a lot worse if you don't pack up and leave me alone.
Okay, obviously right now is not the most opportune time to talk, but hey, what about later? You know, we hook up after work and have a little whiskey tasting, I think.
Jake, I don't know if you're the most optimistic person on the planet or if you just suffered brain damage in the shower this morning or what. Get it through your skull. I don't like you.
Liar. I think you have real feelings for me, so we should talk about these feelings tonight over drinks, in bed, with no pants on.
Oh, my God, would you get over yourself? I don't want to see you naked, all right?
Okay. If it'll help seal the deal, you take your pants off and I'll leave mine on.
Oh, my God. What?
I think we have a bit of a situation here.
That's a robbery, Jake. We gotta stop him.
Stop, police!
Hey!
Amazing gathering of people with this, like, special skill set.
What kind of skill set?
Well, I'm glad you asked.
It's a group of individuals who have the ability to predict, well, actually, no, determine certain outcomes in the near future in, like, a fair-type setting.
Fair-type setting? Des, what kind of fair is this?
Like a psychic fair.
Like a psychic fair.
Okay, it is a psychic fair, but it's really, really good times. It's only in town for 3 days. Thoughts, questions, concerns?
It sounds great, but I can't.
Okay. No, totally.
No. Des, no. It's not that. I don't want you to think. does. I'm just super busy. I gotta go. I'm sorry.
It's just the last time I was there, they said there'd be trouble in my near future. And the next day I met Jake. Wild, what? Hello? Hello? Hello?
It's okay, Desi. She likes you.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, she's crazy about me. That's probably why she hung up on me.
Who the hell is Jake? Said he's coming back with supper half an hour ago.
Yeah, he once left me outside a strip club holding a man's boot for 12 to 13 hours, and then he yelled at me for being late for work.
He probably just got distracted. It's one happy hour, big deal.
It's not just any happy hour. It's the second Friday of the month.
Half-price whiskey tasting. Check the hospitals.
I'll call open line, put out a missing person.
I'll go pick up the phone myself. Dennis, come with me.
Oh. Hey, Jenny, what's up? Where's Uncle Jake? I'm just trying to track him down right now.
I said get out! You know you don't mean that!
What's going on there? What's happening?
Mom's kind of freaking out at Eric.
Are you two okay?
I'm fine. I'm more worried for him than for her.
Okay, I'll be right there.
In some kind of warehouse. They're gonna come in after us, and we know that they're armed.
Somebody just left the cab.
What are you doing?
Well, we gotta get the jump on him.
We don't know where we are or how many people he's got out there.
I'm pretty sure there's two of them, okay? And you left one of them back around the road, which was very, very attractive how you handled that, by the way.
Oh my God, Jake.
Well, I'm just saying.
Oh, yeah, the battery's dead. I wonder why with how much you've been calling it.
I got no signal, neither.
What's going on?
Sounds like they're smashing at the lock with a friggin' crowbar.
Come on out, you won't get hurt. We just bought one of the boxes.
Yeah. You seem like really nice folks, so I'll get right on that.
They're looking for something specific.
They left this behind.
What do you got?
Looks like a key for one of those lock boxes. If we can find what it is that they're looking for.
Then we'll have something to bargain with. Stop trying.
Your son is a douche, and I hope you know it's not easy for me to say so.
He ordered the food, and then what?
Oh, he booted after the blonde cop. He's got no chance with.
So he was with Leslie. Which way did they go?
$39.95, and I'll give you a hint.
$40?
What a rip.
Hey, the food was 23 even. Plus $10 for storage and an automatic 20% gratuity for the trouble.
I got to live, Malachi.
All right. He chased her down freshwater, like the pathetic fool he is. Oh, don't tell him I said that.
Two large fries, please.
There's Jake's car. And Leslie's.
Yeah, but Ziggy says they went the other way.
It just isn't working, okay? I got enough going on right now. You just have to go.
No, I'm not going. I'm not going to go.
No.
Why are you doing this?
Hey,
somebody want to tell me what's going on here?
Rose, I'm sorry, okay? But Eric's got to go.
All of a sudden. Okay, everybody, just take a deep breath, okay? Somebody tell me what happened.
Okay, she just decides that she doesn't want to see me all of a sudden, so now I just got to leave just like that.
Eric, stop talking now before I lose my patience.
Come on. No,
Eric.
No,
stop.
Don't worry.
Hey, Kathy, you need a hand
see,
here?
What you don't understand is that I love her. I love her!
Okay, I'm out of here. Tinny!
Eric, listen to me. You can't come back here, or there's gonna be some trouble.
The thing is that, I didn't do anything wrong.
I don't care. That's irrelevant information. Go home. Go. So, Kath, what the heck was that all about?
You know what? It's a long, long story. It has nothing to do with Eric. He was just being too drunk and too clingy. He had to go.
Obviously. The real problem is much, much worse. You want to tell me about it?
Did you try the other one?
Do you want a different answer from the last 14 times that you asked me that?
Jake, you don't need to be a tool.
Boys, would you give it a rest for just 5 seconds, please?
Well, it's nice of them to oblige.
You left me on the side of the road? Are you an idiot?
Well, you knew where you were going.
Now stop calling me an idiot. Seriously.
There's definitely two of them, and they're fighting.
We gotta find a way out of here.
Must be a couple.
You're so cynical. Give me the key.
What?
Give it to me.
Suit yourself.
Leave your mask on, idiot. I mean, idiot.
You know that word messes with my confidence. I told you that before.
Okay, just keep your cool. We need to get them out, and now.
Something in one of these boxes is worth an awful lot to them.
Well, look at you with the lucky touch.
Yeah, I'm trapped in the back of an armored van with you, and you think I'm lucky? This is worth something.
Yeah, you should try some of that on. It'll look good on you. Hey, bellheads! I think we got what you're looking for.
Yeah, rile them up, why don't you?
Safer inside?
Yeah, you'd think so. But there have been some complaints about items going missing and stuff. Certain customers wanted their belongings moved, so we did. And, I got tasered for the trouble.
Maybe Jake and Leslie, they just patched things up and just ran away together. That'd be nice, wouldn't it?
For some reason, I doubt that.
No, but Jake's got this kind of, like, magnetism. It's almost animal. Like a lot of class.
Sergeant Hood, you don't happen to know where Leslie Bennett's to?
Somewhere's buying shoes is my guess.
That's so sexist, man.
Meanwhile, it's left to me to pick up the armored van robbery 2 blocks from her last call.
Did anyone see anything?
What? I got a report to you now, too? Ask the witness yourself.
If you don't mind.
Fill your boots.
You mind telling me what happened here? I think my son might have been witness.
Well, it all happened so fast, you know. There was a robbery. I was hurt, but I'll live.
Right on. So what now?
See if we can get access to the security tapes. Rose?
Any word from Jake?
No, not yet.
Well, call around, will you?
I'm going to check out the usual haunts.
Mal, are you actually getting worried?
I don't know. Something doesn't feel right. I'll buzz you later. Des?
Mm.
Tapes.
Yes.
Okay, so back out west, the guy, remember, who was bothering me? Okay, he got freaky. Will Andrews. We were dating, and then I found out that he was married. I dumped him, and he didn't take it well. So I came back home to get away from him.
It's okay, honey. It's okay.
Right? Just tell me what you want to do.
Mom. Oh, but... Somebody just slipped this under the door. What the hell is going on?
You wrecked my life, you tramp. I'm getting even.
Yeah.
Not cool.
We're only slowing it down.
You're right. We gotta get out of here. Here's what we're gonna do, okay? You give me your gun, all right? I go out and shoot until you're safe, then you follow me.
Yeah, I'm just gonna hand over my service weapon and hide. That's just so like me, Jake.
All right, fine. Okay, plan B. All right, you cover me, all right? And then I'll go grab the keys until you get out.
No, I cover you. You hide until I come get you. Simple.
Fine, whatever. We stay there, we're gonna die. Wait. For luck.
Jake, put my gun back in the holster. What do you think I am?
It was worth a shot.
This is starting to get out of hand.
Starting to get out of hand? Look, there is no going back now.
My arms hurt and I'm sweaty.
Why do your arms hurt?
I don't know. I'm tired.
Oh, for the love. It's just a little longer. They will give up soon.
Jake!
Wait!
What are you doing?
Wait, stop running. You, wait.
Stop!
idiot. It tears me down. It tears me down.
That was not the plan.
Yeah, well, not going to be able to smoke this out anymore.
Bob, what's wrong? What are you being such a baby about your shoulder for? Let me see.
Ah!
Jake, you've been shot.
No, I haven't. No, I haven't.
Okay. We gotta stop the blood.
Yeah. I should have got shot a long time ago.
Don't get any ideas.
I think I'm gonna need a bigger bandage. You better take off your pants, too.
Hold on, Jake. Hold on.
Pocket those. They really would look spectacular on you.
Shh. Lie quiet. You're burning up.
Is your shirt still off?
Jake, be good.
What is that noise?
The happy couple's got a new toy.
Oh.
Jake, you've lost a lot of blood.
That's a blowtorch. That might work, unfortunately.
Get back here, bucko.
Look, if we don't get out of here and they burst through those doors, they're gonna pick us off like flies.
You're right. Okay. Good news is, I managed to save one bullet.
All right, we're gonna have to make it count.
What are you thinking?
Who's the better shot, you or me?
I'm a 3-time All-Newfoundland Best Bullet Champion, and you're a private eye. Who doesn't own a gun?
Okay, I think I got a plan.
I did it. I got the security tapes. I did exactly what Jake would do, and it worked. I broke 4 or 5 major laws, and I dished out $200 to the girl who works nights at the deposit box place, and I got a copy of the security cameras.
Okay, what'd you find?
Nothing. The robbers had sprayed them all over.
Not exactly money well spent, son.
But I went to the Chinese restaurant next door, and I got this. Check it out. Oh, by the way, do you think I can get that $200 petty cash? I also picked up some Whoppers.
Shh. Watch.
Right in the neck. Yes, bye. That would hurt, actually. No.
Back it up. Just before. There. The guard flinched before he was tasered. Either the guard knew the taser was coming,
or he has eyes in the back of his head, which is highly unlikely, I guess.
The guard's in on this.
That's what I meant.
Let's go pay him a visit. Nothing from Jake.
What? Oh, no, I was actually checking to see if Chandra called. I mean, not that I'm not worried about Jake. It's just I think I might be moving too fast with her. Or maybe too slow. Or maybe we should stop moving altogether. I don't know. What do you think?
Now is not a good time for that, Des. Keep a lookout.
What are you going to do?
Just a friendly chat.
Oh, my God.
Come clean now or the arm comes off.
Hey, man, I already told you. I have no idea, man.
I know you're in on the robbery. Just tell me where they are now.
I don't have any idea. Okay. Hey, the guy paid me off to take a dive. All I know is that they're in a warehouse down by the chain museum. That's all I know, man.
Des, call Hood. He's going to want to talk to Kenny here.
Hey.
Forget him. We need to find Jake before Kenny tips off the other robber. Come on.
Okay.
They're almost through. I'd say they're about seconds from getting through that door.
You ready? You only got one shot at this. Sure you don't want me to do it?
Listen, you worry about your job, I'll worry about mine. Plus, you already owe me for one blouse. Ready? Set?
Go.
What is this?
Paint? Take it easy.
I'm sorry. I got it! Come on, let's go!
Jules, you gotta go after
him. I'm not going anywhere.
He hit you. I'll kill him.
fine. I can take a hit with the best of them. So shut up, okay?
Okay.
Jake,
hold on.
How bad is it? Get emergency surgery. Watch it.
Honestly, I like it better when you're half naked, but I have to admit that jacket does look good on you.
Sorry, I had to borrow it. How you doing?
Dandy. So what do you say? Let's get out of here. Go track down those jewels.
You try and get out of that bed, and I'm gonna handcuff you to it.
Is that a promise?
Stay put. Hey, how's he doing? He just woke up. He's trying to check himself out.
I'll go see how he is. I'll come with you.
Kathleen.
Well, is he okay? I mean, is Jake...
Yeah, he's fine. It's just a scratch. Listen, we need to talk about your friend Will Anders.
You know what? Just tell me that he's way back in Calgary dating some other girl who has no idea he's a deadbeat.
He's in town.
What?
I found a receipt. Of him hiring a local cab company. We've got to do something about this.
Yeah, I really don't want Dad worrying about anything else, you know, with Jake being in the hospital, so please, please, please don't tell him.
Of course. But we need to meet soon.
Yeah, okay.
Anything to get a day off.
You're supposed to be sad, you know, a few tears would be nice.
Walk it off would be fine.
Did they catch him?
Not yet.
They had help. It was an inside job.
Security guard.
Yeah, but put that out of your head and rest. You've been shot. And I haven't had a bite to eat all day, thanks to somebody. Leave it to the cops. I'm serious. And stop getting shot. Oh, for the record, I'm glad you're not dead.
So did you feel the actual steel, like, slicing through your skin and your flesh and your muscle, never to be totally the same ever again?
Yeah, listen. Go over there and grab my shirt, quick.
Sure. Oh, and look, I don't mean to get blunt with you or anything, but Mal told me not to let you leave this room, and I'm not afraid to get physical.
I'll keep that in mind.
Hey, Chandra, hey. You remember my detective partner, Jake Doyle?
Of course.
Wow, Dez, you were totally right. She is spectacularly gorgeous.
Glad to see you haven't lost your sense of humor.
Will he walk again?
I think he'll be fine. He's the real strong, grin and bear it kind. Can't keep guys like that down for long. I've seen his type before.
So you've dated that kind before? I mean, that's the kind of guy you're into. You're into the alpha male, top dog, strong, big alpha guy who's...
I'll be right back, okay? And you get out of here. Okay, I need to examine him all.
Okay. Bye. Oh, my God, my life is falling apart. First, I have a near brush with death, 1 degree removed, and now Chandra, she's not even into me anymore. I need to be more assertive. I need to be more alpha, less beta.
You know, you might be right. Get up, take off your coat.
What? Why? You need something?
Listen, you want to be a real man? Take off your shirt now.
That doesn't make any sense to me.
Do what I say, Dez. Take off your shirt.
Right. Okay, buttons.
Hurry, faster.
I just...
Go.
Okay. All right. No.
Go get her.
Chandra!
I'm gonna need that jacket back.
Jake! What are you doing?
What? The doc released me. What do you say we go track down a couple of skeets who are robbing some jewelry? Little over here.
You are in no condition.
You were worried about me, were you? Did you think I was gonna die?
No.
Yes, you did. Tell the truth.
What is this? Jake, what are you doing? What am I doing?
Well, technically, we're making out in a morgue, which I guess it is kind of inappropriate. So what do you say we just cool it and we take our time, okay?
All right. But you're not going anywhere except straight to bed.
That goes against everything I just said, but if you want to go to bed, that's cool too.
Stop it. I'm serious. You're not leaving this hospital.
All right. Guess you don't want to know who was in on that job then.
What do you got?
Not so fast. Not unless we have a deal. Okay, you go this alone, or you let me in. What do you got?
Nothing, really. The jewelry belonged to some old woman who passed away a few weeks ago. That's it.
Well, I guess you got a choice to make. Either you commit me, or we do this together.
Deal. Spill it.
It's an inside job. Can you help me with my coat, please? So what do you say we go track down a security guard?
Well, we'll have to get a new camera. Or wait, find out what it takes to clean it. Yeah.
Excuse me. You work here?
Yes, officer. What can I do for you?
We're looking for an employee. His name is Kenny.
Kenny? Excuse me? No, he's already left for the day. Why are you looking for him?
There seems to be some evidence that he may have participated in the robbery today.
No way. Kenny? Most days he's not smart enough to put his socks on right. No. Don't try to clean it yourself.
Look, he's got some paint from the explosion.
You tell me this guy's our mail robber.
So, we all good here?
Oh, yeah, buddy. We are best kind. Let's go follow him. I think I should drive.
Yes, by knows you will.
Why can't I drive?
It's my car.
It's car.
Stop! Put your hands in the air!
Oh, God.
You see, they totally followed you.
No, they did not. They followed you.
Likely.
Tell her, who'd you follow? Who do you think we followed, idiot?
Don't move.
It's not what it looks like.
Oh, so you didn't rob a security company then?
No, I did. I mean, we did, but we had a good reason.
Yeah, very, very good reason.
Turn around. Put your hands behind your head.
Leslie! Go, go, go!
You're gonna cut me out of my chair, Roger?
No!
Put down your weapon!
Try it, you guys! Barbara, bring the jewelry and get in the truck!
Don't you shoot me, Leslie! I was already shot once today! Ow. Stop them! You gotta stop them!
Stay where you are!
No, you don't understand! I had to do it! We needed the money for our child! It sounds weird, but you gotta understand.
Understand? You pulled a heist.
Yeah, but it was for the right reasons. It was for my child's future.
See, that's the problem. We have no record of you having a kid. No birth certificate, no name.
Dirk, if it's a boy, and Jasmine, if it's a girl.
Your wife's pregnant?
No. No, not yet. But that's why we needed the money.
Huh. We should hear about.
I know what we did was wrong, but we didn't have a choice. Okay, Barbara, my wife, she's wanted a baby for a long time, but I have some problems in that area, so.
He shoots blanks.
And not that it makes me any less of a man, but I need help, and it's expensive.
Yeah, well, in vitro fertilization can be. My sister. So you and your wife thought that robbing an armored van was the best way to deal with your fertility worries?
Well, we had to, because Barbara was running out of time. She felt like it was her last chance, and we needed money fast. So...
So you robbed an armored van?
I couldn't just open the box and walk out. I would have got caught. So we cut Kenny in on it. It was kind of his idea. But now Kenny thinks we were going to cheat him out of his share because you guys showed up, so you took Babs and... You got to get my wife back.
Let's go. You believe in any of that?
Well, I believe that Roger does. I mean, obviously he loves his wife to buy any old foolish story that you tell him. Either way, there's definitely more going on here. We gotta track down Barbara and Kenny to get the truth.
Let me see that. We are not going anywhere.
Out, Leslie, but
Oh, come on, we were doing so well.
If you die, I'm gonna kill you. You're getting escorted back to the hospital.
What the hell are you thinking? Can a father grab a bite without someone getting in the line of fire?
Look, I'm the one who got shot, all right? The least I can do is find out what the hell is going on.
You stay in that hospital bed. Dodge Dez again, I'll skin you.
So, I thought I might drop by later. Or maybe not, because I have some exciting, manly things.
How's that sound?
You're asking me if that's what you should say to Chandra.
Yeah, well, you're a girl, kind of. I mean...
What does that sound like to you?
I'm kind of a girl. Dez? I don't care what you say to your girlfriend. Stop calling me.
No, Tinny, you were totally a girl. You were so much a girl. She was wondering if... Man, my shirt looks awesome on you.
Dez, what do you have on Kenny?
Me? Nothing. I haven't been working the case at all.
Look, I know Father told you not to tell me anything, but tell me anyway.
No. Yes. Okay, don't put me in the middle of this man fight, all right? I suck at tug of war.
Look, I am handcuffed to a hospital bed, okay? At least just humor me. It's what you do for a friend when you visit them in the hospital.
Friend? Really? I knew you felt the same way. Come here, man.
I'm sorry.
Here, no, I forgot.
Don't touch me. Don't touch me.
Okay, I'm sorry. I should have brought a car. I was going to bring a car, but then I thought that you might think it was presumptuous or something weird like that.
Dez, Kenny.
Right, I got his home addy.
Nice, give it to me. Okay, I need a pen.
What? Why?
I need a pen, Dez, in case I get a cast. I'm going to have to get you to sign it for me.
Well, why would you have need a cast?
Ow. Okay, Dez, this is all a part of your training, so I'm going to need you to relax and embrace the pain. Embrace the pain. Okay, this is part of your training.
Okay.
Okay? Embrace it.
Hurts a lot.
Yeah? There you go. Keep your hand right there. Stay right there.
Ow, no.
There you go.
No. Ow, that's really tight. Jake, I thought we were friends. We said we were friends. You said we were friends. Tell Mel I fought back, okay? Tell him I fought back. Where are you going? Get him out of my shirt. Jake!
So, Leslie, you want to get together and solve a robbery or something?
Jake, you got out of those cuffs. You need treatment for that wound, Jake.
Look, do you want the address where Kenny's squatting or not? Because I'll only give it to you if you let me come with
him. So he's in town? What's our next move?
Well, I'm thinking we should probably go to the police if Will sends another one of those letters or, God forbid, does something worse.
Mom, what's going on? So it turns out Will wasn't the one sending you those letters.
I was.
Okay. Listen, I swear I had no idea that Will was married, and when I did, I ended it.
Yeah. 2 months later, you did. Okay, you know what? Why don't we just sit down and talk this through like adults, eh?
You stay away from Will! Back off! Okay? You calm down.
Well, let's just try and think straight here for a second.
Seriously, you guys, how friggin' old are you?
Come on.
Okay, what is it that you actually want?
I want a divorce. He's cheated on me a dozen times. I'm tired of fighting all you whores off.
That's it. I'm good. Whoa, Mom!
Okay, Kathleen probably could help you with this somehow. Right?
And how's the tramp supposed to do that?
She's got a point. Did you just call me a tramp?
Mm-hmm.
Mom, can you clean up your mess? Please?
Okay. You have a lawsuit? I'm guessing here.
Yeah. So? Not that it's any of your business.
So, I have pictures. I have, detailed pictures. That can maybe help you with your lawsuit.
And pick up my bill at the B&B. Will found out I was racking up charges and canceled the credit card.
Okay, deal. I'll get you the pictures and you go away and you never come back.
Fine. I will see you in the AM.
What did you say to her?
Nothing. Nothing.
You're too much, you know that?
Thank you.
Always gotta be the hero, always gotta do it yourself.
Look, it could have been you.
What?
the bullet that hit me, it could have hit you. And it's not like I'm just going to lie back and wait while you solve this thing.
Do I need to remind you that I work in law enforcement?
This is the one here.
And that I'm one of the top-ranked officers in the RNC?
I know.
Police!
Well, that was hot.
Well, you want to fight your own battles. This is a perfect one for you. Give her.
Sir? You want to get up there?
Uh-oh.
Where's the jewelry? Where'd you stash it?
Does it matter? Nothing matters. You don't understand, man. We had this thing. We had this plan. Had to do with love. You know the name of that song, right? What's that song?
Look, buddy, we're having a bit of a crap day, all right? So just answer the question.
Sorry. What was the question?
The jewelry. Where is it?
Barbara took it. Took the jewelry and everything. Along with my heart.
So run this for us one more time.
Okay. So I bring Barbara back to my place, and I'm freaking out as I got a lot of money and jewelry.
$250,000.
Right. And like, the most beautiful woman in the world.
Barbara? You and Barbara were?
Yeah, we were seeing each, but like on the down low on account of her husband. You know, but I'm thinking, Barbara wakes up and she figures, hey, she wants to be with me like full time. But she can't here. But if we had the money to start a new life...
So you decide to pull this big job and then make Roger your patsy.
Right. But she tells Roger that she needs the cash for making babies or whatever. But in truth, she wants the dough that she can run away with me. You can see I'm just the innocent victim here.
Yeah, well, I think I can put you in jail for something. Let's go.
Wait. I'll totally flip. Freedom for information. Deal?
We'll see about the deal. Do you know where Barbara is?
No idea. But as you can see, like, it's not my fault. I mean, if all of that stuff hadn't gone missing from the deposit box place, well, we wouldn't have been moving anything.
Oh. There were other robberies?
Yeah, a couple of people complained. You know, dead people mostly. Their families, like when they came with the will. To collect their inheritance.
And who was robbing the stuff?
Roger was using his key to steal from security boxes when the owners died to build his baby-making fund.
So what, this was like one big last score?
Where'd he stash the rest of the loot?
Well, I'll tell you where if you like, you know, give me the deal.
Really having to work hard for her money today.
I almost feel bad for her. There's the bag of loot that her husband must have stole.
Stay where you are, or I'll shoot. Barbara, drop the bag, hands in the air. Last chance. Not a move. Stay where you are.
No, you can't arrest me. You can't. I'm pregnant.
Barbara, we know for a fact that Roger is infertile.
But Kenny isn't. I think it's time you told us the whole story here.
Roger and I had been trying for over a year with no success. And after a while, it, you know, started to be more like work than...
what it should be?
Yeah. And then Kenny came along. And he was fun. And one thing led to another.
Ooh. You started having sex with Kenny to take your mind off having sex with Roger.
And the next thing you know...
you ended up preggers, eh?
I didn't know what to do, so I panicked and I came up with this stupid idea to rob an armored van.
You know, I'm still not really following your logic here.
I thought if I could get enough money for the in vitro fertilization treatment, then I could trick Roger into thinking that the baby was his. But I had to do it quickly, because I'd start showing too soon.
So wait a minute. You thought you could trick Roger
into thinking Kenny's baby was his?
Well, I have a 50-50 shot, right? I don't know what I was thinking.
You weren't.
What's gonna happen to my baby?
Hey. What's with you?
Nothing. Nothing. I'm too tough for problems, you know that.
Oh.
I'm screwed. Chandra's totally over me. She saw me handcuffed once, and then she saw me naked from the waist up another time.
Really? You really don't want to know that, Des?
She's just always too busy for me. And then with Jake, she's like laughing, and she's paying attention to his alpha pheromones.
Why would you want to be like Uncle Jake? You've seen his relationships. They're train wrecks, right?
Just give it to me straight. Do you think I should break up with Chandra before she breaks up with me?
Just do something and stop moping around. Nobody's into that.
Sure this is the right thing to do?
She's pregnant, and we have a process for this kind of thing. The hospital's the best place for her and her child right now.
Barbara, tell me it's not true. Tell me you didn't lie.
Sorry. I didn't want you to hate me.
No, I love you. And I love the baby, too, even if it's not mine.
Maybe they should have talked things out.
Well, you know, it's a lot more fun to get into a bit of armed robbery.
Are you okay? You don't look right.
I'm the best. This man.
Jake, can I get some help here?
Stay there.
You're okay. Oh, yeah.
All right. Everything checks out, and no more disappearing acts. I'm coming back with a shot that'll keep you in this bed till next Thursday.
Sleep well, son, because I'm gonna murder you the first chance I get. Stop being an idiot.
That's the plan.
Leslie. Thank you.
Hey. Hi. I was wondering if you were free for dinner tonight.
Des, I would love to. And I know I've been a terrible girlfriend, but...
Girlfriend? I mean, girlfriend. So it's official. I mean... Girlfriend. Cool.
Maybe we can find some time next week. I just can't leave the hospital right now, right?
No. Hey, so you don't have to. I just checked out the vending machine, and I can put together a six-course meal for $7.50. I'll clean that up. I can put together a six-course meal for $7.50. Now, that's if you count Jam Jams as appetizers, which, of course, you would. So, I'll just wait here in the lobby until you get a break.
Let's make it the on-call room. More private. Barbara and Roger pled to a deal. They copped to everything in exchange for Roger being able to see the baby when it's born.
The things we do for the people we love. You and me, though, I feel like we really made quite the team.
Yeah, I was thinking about us. As a team?
I don't think I like that tone at all.
Jake, what happened? Happened. You and me, when we're together, we make a lot of problems for a lot of people. Mostly me.
I was the one who got shot.
Exactly. We both know what's best here. And it doesn't involve you and me walking off into the sunset together. We need to back off.
Sure about that?
No. But that's what's gonna happen.
All right. Great. Fine.